My name is Rodger Cornell. I'm an explosives engineer.
Oh my God, how do they walk away in movies without flinching when it explodes behind them? There's no way!
Okay, so as soon as this clip starts, there are a couple really pressing issues that you should be focusing on. The first is that if you have grenades and other weapons, you shouldn't be carrying them around inside a guitar case. On top of that, as soon as he pulls the grenades out, you'll notice that he pulls out not one, but two of those pins with his teeth. I've tried it a few times and you really have to put all of your strength to get that thing dislodged. So pulling any kind of grenade pin out with your mouth, unless it's been tampered with beforehand, is just completely unrealistic.
Jesus Christ.
The most common misconceptions I'm aware of. One is that any explosive device, when it goes off, will throw a human being into the air. The detonation itself and the pressure wave, they're gonna do plenty of damage to the human body. Propelling you into the air isn't gonna be one of the things that you experience. So being thrown is not really a thing. You also see that just from those two grenades, you have this gigantic fireball. Grenades, especially a military grenade, is going to be composed of what's called secondary explosives. And these secondary explosives go through detonation processes. A detonation process is extremely rapid, and it's certainly not going to be this prolonged explosion that you see here. When you see a gigantic fireball and you see just flames everywhere, you can usually assume that they're exaggerating quite a bit. I mean, it's not that surprising. It's a Quentin Tarantino movie, so I really wouldn't expect anything less. The only explosive device that you see in that clip is what seems to be one pack of dynamite. Dynamite's used specifically for blasting operations. So even though it's made for situations like this, if you have just one bundle in the corner of a house, you will never get any kind of an explosion on this order. You might have a chunk of the house missing right where that explosive charge was, but that's about it. The house would probably still be standing unless there were a lot of other charges placed throughout the house that we're unaware of. Certainly not every piece of the building would be in flames. The refrigerator is lead lined. And the reason this is important is that lead can actually block certain types of radiation. Right off the bat, it's Michael Bay, it's a Transformers movie, you have Decepticons running around, so you know, how real can you expect it to be? When you see the fighter jets in action, you'll notice these bursts of light coming off the bottom. If I had to guess what that would probably be flares, and a lot of times they're used so the planes can avoid heat-seeking missiles. They're a source of heat that can distract the missile from continuing to fly towards the jet. Now, whether or not Decepticons use heat-seeking missiles, I have no idea.
V1 snap 090, you are approved to drop your 2,000-pound JDAM.
So during this initial explosion, what I'm assuming they're doing is essentially marking their target. If you're gonna drop munitions that don't have any kind of propulsion or guidance, that you wanna be very, very sure where you're gonna drop those bombs. You see Shia LaBeouf get just almost catapulted into the air. It almost actually looks like he's stepping on like a trampoline. I can't see any reason why he would be tumbling in the air like that. The pressure wave that's radiating, you know, is moving outward, away from the explosion. So if you were to be thrown at all, you might be thrown backwards and fall to the ground. But setting that all aside, there's at least realistic situations. Some of the things that the aircraft did, that progression from marking your target and then dropping the energetic load on top of it, my guess is that he was probably consulted as to how the, you know, how the Department of Defense would actually go through their procedures. He takes essentially his claws and he strikes them against the rocks to create a spark to initiate the flame. If I'm remembering correctly, it's adamantium, what his claws are made of, which is completely fictitious. I have no idea what the properties of that material would be, but there are a lot of metals out there that don't spark. There are other ways to initiate fuel. That seems like a pretty silly one that probably wouldn't work out. You know, that's a very rocky surface. Even if you got it to start burning, it would probably die out before it ever reached the helicopter. I would never expect this to explode. You have a helicopter that's crashed and that's already leaking fuel. So when the fuel tank ruptures, there's no pressure vessel that can heat up, that can allow pressure to build, where you'd actually get some sort of an explosion. But if you had an explosion on that scale, you'd have pieces of that helicopter being thrown in every direction, not to mention the pressure wave that's produced. So he would definitely hit the ground at some point. He regenerates, so I guess you could walk away from this and he'd be fine. You see some grenade being launched at Hancock, and he somehow deflects it into a car. If we just accept the fact that he can't be hurt and that he can just deflect bullets and that's fine, there are still really big issues with this scene. The effect of the grenade is unrealistic. The way it initiates is incorrect. Using the police car as, you know, a way of stopping bullets is just ill-advised. Cars don't stop bullets. Cars can deflect bullets. Cars have a lot of weak points, so you wouldn't want to ever use it as a shield. I'd expect the doors to have bulletproof inserts, but that's about it. The roof of the car and the floor of the car are probably pretty thin. Those are going to be the most vulnerable parts of that vehicle. The way he's holding it is probably the least safe way that you could be using that car for protection.
Good job!
To create an explosion that massive, you would need more explosive material than you could carry with you, and you would need to plant it everywhere. It would take just unlimited financial resources, a huge amount of time to place the charges where you need to put them. They try to add in some cool sound effects. It's not going to sound anything like that. The actual audio event is very rapid, it's very loud, and it's more of a crack. They try to show the shock actually moving outward, essentially past Denzel. You can see the grass start to move forward and then retract back. There, you see that little, that was a shock wave moving past. So seeing that sort of motion within the grass in that scene could actually be realistic. If you're that close where you can see the shock around you, it's gonna at least hurt because you have this sudden change in pressure. That's gonna feel like someone's at the very least just punching you as hard as they can. You're not just gonna keep walking. All sorts of metals being thrown. There's fragmentation everywhere. Unreasonable is to pull that off. It would be expensive. And you'd also need to somehow, you know, go through a hospital and place all these charges without anybody noticing.
Explode!
Oh my God, Rose windows!
What the f*** is
blow
that
it
up?
The funny thing is, this scene is one of the most realistic scenes we're probably gonna see. There is one resounding issue with this scene though. All those pressurized tanks, the fact that all these things are ruptured and just sitting there.
What happened?
I don't know, it just didn't explode.
That's weird.
That would never happen.
I really thought that one was gonna explode.
This, I think, is actually the most accurate scene. So you have a fuel tank that was just riddled with bullet holes, so it has no way of accelerating the reaction.
Oh, that's what exploded?
I don't know why chickens would explode. Their fecal matter could probably combust. The wooden cages could light on fire. But why you'd get an explosion, I have no idea. I think the scene's kind of intending to be a bit ridiculous, and it definitely is.
What accounting firm is closed at 11 a.m. on a Tuesday?
Oh, this is a
hole.
The flame's unrealistic, but the way they're pushed back is actually somewhat believable. So, you know, the fact that they aren't cut up and that they're not bleeding profusely, the fragmentation in that situation would be much more deadly.
I can't hear! I can't hear!
The way he's complaining is unrealistic, but the fact that he's complaining about his ears is actually realistic. You know, when you have blast overpressure, there are certain parts of the human body that are susceptible, that are very susceptible to shifts in pressure. Your eardrums are one, and your lungs are another. In extreme cases, if the pressure was strong enough, you could rupture your lungs. And if that happens, or if anything near that happens, you know, he's not gonna be talking. You know, he's just gonna be laying there gasping for whatever breath he can pull in. So he seems to be in much better shape than I would imagine him to be. If you got hit with a pressure wave, you'd probably be concussed as well.
I need an MRI!
So an MRI might not be a bad idea.
Walk away in movies without flinching when it explodes behind them. There's no way. I call bull on that.